Welcome back. History was not made on the Vancouver Canucks side last night. Teams that have a 3-1 series lead typically advance to the next round 91% of the time. And last night, the Canucks fell in line and are now booking tee times. They were on a power play of their own here to work with. And Canucks have a great power play, of course, with Sedin. Both Sedins back. And they score there. 1-0 Canucks after one. Early in the third, Drew Doughty to Brad Richardson. And he jams it in past Schneider. We're tied at one to overtime. Crazy chance for the Canucks. Mason Raymond to win it. Tries the wraparound, goes off the post, and then goes off of Jonathan Quick, stays out. Then Hamhuis is hauled down. Kings break in, 2-on-1. Jarrett Stoll, Saskatoon kid, perfect shot. The Canucks will not contend for a cup this time around. Los Angeles eliminates Vancouver in five. And for the first time in 11 years, the Kings have advanced to the second round after knocking off the number one seed in the West. Bruins and the Caps are next. Caps lead the series 3-2 heading in. Andrew Ferrance shoots. Rich Peverley tips it in. Bruins lead 1-0, but Washington responds. Mike Green, good Calgary kid. Tees it up, goes off a defender and in. We are tied at one. And then the Caps face off in the offensive zone. Quick release by Alexander Ovechkin. A.O. his second. It's 3-3. We are going to overtime. And 3 minutes in, Backstrom's pass intercepted. Lucic to Tyler Seguin, his first of the playoffs. The Bruins stay alive. What a game from Washington as we are headed to a game seven in this series, 4-3 in overtime, the final. Finally, Flyers and the Pens early on the day yesterday. Right off the opening faceoff, that's Claude Giroux hitting Sidney Crosby to set the tone. And then 27 seconds later, Giroux scores his sixth of the series. It's 1-0. Sign man there already has a sign for Claude. Second period, a goal that Fleury really should have had. Eric Gustafson goes upstairs. Feels shame on that one. 3-0 Philly. They add an empty netter for the 5-1 final to eliminate Crosby and the crew from the playoffs. Claude Giroux, the 24-year-old, had 3 points in that series. All right, sticking with hockey, but focusing on the AJHL, the Brooks Bandits played host to the Penticton V's on Saturday, and they lost by a score of 1-0, and now the V's lead the series 2-0. The Bandits outshot the V's 43-30. The rest of the games will now be played in Penticton at the South Okanagan Event Center. And the dates are as follows. Game 3 is tomorrow, Game 4 Wednesday, with Game 5, if needed, on Friday. Hundreds of young girls made a splash at the provincial synchronized swimming competition. The Lethbridge Synchro Bells and dozens of teams from across the province competed in the Wild Rose Classic on Saturday. Girls from 7 to 17 showed off group duet and solo swim routines. Several local athletes scored marks in the top 10. This was the first time in 15 years Lethbridge has hosted the event, and athletes and coaches were glad to have a home crowd.
I was hosted here. I actually was a swimmer, so I swam, and so it's really neat to have it back here in our home pool where all the girls can invite all their friends.
It's fun, it keeps you active, and it's just a great sport for girls.
And one of the Synchro Bell coaches, Sarah Kite, will compete in the World Master Championship in Italy this June, by the way. Three Lethbridge athletes will represent the city in a national fitness competition. The three CrossFit Lethbridge athletes are among the top 60 Canadian men and women who competed in the CrossFit Games. Joey Lutz, Jason Tilsley, and Heather Gillespie will head to Vancouver for regionals this week. They will compete in the workouts that involve weightlifting and strength exercises. Athletes credit their success to the gym's training programs and supportive atmosphere there.
Yeah, it's awesome. Yeah, it means we're doing something right with the competitive group, right? So we appeal to your general fitness enthusiasts, and then we have a group of like more competitive athletes here.
Wow, I got to get in shape. The top two men and women at the competition will go on to California to compete in the world event.
And speaking of all this tough competition, There was another big competition in Lethbridge this weekend, but this one involves diapers,